So, it was what is our aim? To determine the acceleration due to gravity by means of compound pendulum. So, we will use compound pendulum to determine gravity. We'll discuss why we are measuring gravity here. And the second one is to determine radius of gyration about an axis through the center of gravity for the compound pendulum. Means, we'll discuss the how to calculate radius of gyration about an axis through the center of gravity. Here we are using word compound pendulum because the theory of calculating the gravity and radius of gyration, basically compound pendulum is a example of compound pendulum is a bar pendulum. So we are using word compound pendulum or bar pendulum particularly interchangeably means again and again. Then what we do, need of experiment first we will discuss, and then what is gravity, then we will discuss what is pendulum and what is bar pendulum. So this is our plan of action while discussing this experiment. And for that, when we discuss what is bar pendulum, after that we'll start our practical, and in that we'll discuss procedure, and then we will have some demo about how we'll do it, and then calculations, and errors and precautions. So this is our plan to discuss this. Now, first. Gravity and what is gravity? To discuss that one, you know already some words, gravity or acceleration of gravity. But there is some difference. If you see, what is gravity? Gravity is also called gravitation in mechanics, and the universal force of attraction acting between all the matter. Here the word is all matters. Why we are using it? Because it is not only related to Earth only. When we have two masses, and they have certain distance, separated by certain distance, and it is 100% of phenomena means there will be always a force of attraction between them due to their masses. So it is not only related to Earth or any planet system, it is related to each and every particle which have mass. So that's why we are saying universal force of attraction acting between all the matter means if you are sitting on your chair and a neighbor is sitting along with you, then you will find there will be a force of attraction between both of you. And the magnitude will depend the masses and the circumstances means if you are there and if you are bind with someone else or if you are free, then there will be some acceleration. You know the second law of Newton's second law of motion. But we'll discuss in later on. First, what is gravity or gravitation? It is universal force of attraction means it always exists between two masses or two or more masses. It is by far a weakest known force. Why we are saying weakest known force? Because we know there are a nuclear force, electromagnetic force. So we can categorize them by their strength. In that respect, if you know, if you measure that magnitude of that force, you will find that it is weakest one, except weak forces. Means specifically we name weak forces. We will not going to discuss in the part here, but relatively it is weakest force than your strong forces and electromagnetic forces. It is by far the weakest force known for nature and thus plays no role in determining the internal properties. Means that's why we never discuss while you want to know about the atom structure, electron, proton, neutron, or when you go inside boson, etc. Means higher energy particle. When you discuss, you never discuss gravity over there, because its magnitude is very less in compared to that strong forces that exist over there. But on the other hand, through its long reach and universal action, means it is very long range force and universal action, means everyone is affected by it. It controls the trajectory of body in the solar system. What does it mean? Means if you want to study your solar system, then you will always, you need to consider always this force of attraction, gravitation, whether it is sun and your earth system or sun or Mars or whatever. If you want to discuss your galaxies, your planet system, whatever you will going to, you want to discuss, you will find that there is this huge role of gravitation in discussing that. So this is the need. And what is acceleration of gravity? This is the force which we discussed here in gravity. This is gravity here. But what is acceleration of gravity? It's very simple to understand. Just like nowadays you are watching TV, in that you are, means if you are in a plane, like military operations, and we drop you from that plane. So it is the speed which increases by time. So what we say, what is the change in your velocity with respect to time, or what is the change of velocity per second, is called acceleration. You know the basic definition of acceleration. And acceleration of gravity means the acceleration which exists over there due to gravity. That is called acceleration of gravity. So on Earth, when you drop something from h height, suppose you want to drop from h height, then what you will find, that its velocity increases, and its velocity increases depends on the Earth system, means mass under which you are accelerating yourself. Means if you are on Earth, your acceleration will be different, because force of attraction of gravity is different for different masses. So what is written here? On Earth, all bodies have weight. You know, weight is always there. It is not only for Earth. It is all also for Moon, Mars, whatever you planet you choose, or anything you consider. It all comes on the, there is a role of gravity. So on Earth, all bodies have weight or downward force of gravity, due to which you are falling downwards. If you drop from plane is of mass, a particle of mass m, then you will find there is an acceleration, and this acceleration is due to gravity. And which the acceleration, if you multiply this acceleration with your mass, then you will get the force of attraction. So this is proportional to their masses, which Earth mass exert on them. We'll mathematically we'll discuss in next slide. Gravity is measured by the acceleration that it gives to freely falling object, just like we discussed, that if you drop a particle from plane, you can measure the acceleration, and you can measure the gravity also. If you are able to measure the acceleration, then you can calculate gravity. At Earth surface, it is the standard. At Earth surface, the acceleration of gravity is 9.8 meters. It is a standard value, but it varies with the time and with the place to place also. So what does it mean? If you have a gravity, acceleration of gravity is 9.8 meter per second, it means for every second your object, an object is in free fall, its speed increases by about 9.8 meter per second. Means if you have zero velocity, then next second it will be, your velocity become 9.8 meter per second. So this will increase by Newton's law. You already know laws of motion. S equal to ut plus half a t square, v equal to u plus a t, and etc. So a is here g. By using that, you can calculate. So Newton's these are the some on what factors it depends. So it depends on masses of the body. Since a body of mass experiences a force accelerated at m, means if you want to calculate F equal to ma Newton's second law is there. If you want to calculate acceleration, then F upon m, this is your acceleration. So what means before Newton, Galileo already explained everything, and that all bodies accelerate under gravity towards Earth at same rate. Means it doesn't depend on mass of the body. If you drop a 100 kg stone or a bomb of 100 gram, the acceleration due to gravity will be same on all bodies. This was the observation by Galileo, and which was proved later on by mathematically by Newton. What is Newton's equation? And this was the F12 gm1 m2 upon R12. This is the equation. You already know it is in 12th syllabus. But I observed many of the students do not follow exactly the way we want to explain. So that's why I am repeating all the things. So F12 is the magnitude by which two bodies are attracting each other. Here g is universal constant, and R12 is the distance between these two particles. Now, in case of Earth, if m1 is m, if we replace it, that is mass of the particle, and m2 is me, mass of the Earth. And force, what will be the force? F equal to mg by replacing a by g. G is the acceleration due to gravity. So, you can by this force here and using this F equal to mg relation, you can be able to calculate this one, and g will be g equal to gme upon re square. Means g equal to F upon m, and we replace m by m1 by m, and m2 by me. So by this way you can calculate g. What is important to observe here in g, here capital G is universal constant, means it is everywhere there, and me is mass of the Earth, and re is the radius of the Earth. If you want to observe acceleration due to gravity on Earth surface, then it is re equal to radius of the Earth. On a certain height, it will be re plus h. So but important thing is that g is constant here. If you see here, g is constant, me is constant, re is constant. It means small g means acceleration due to gravity on Earth or any planet will remain constant. This is important thing, and that's why the observation by Galileo was experimentally proved or mathematically proved by Newton. Now weight and mass, you know the weight, whatever reaction force you get when you stand up on a weight weighing machine, you will get your weight. So this is the basically a reaction force which you get after standing on a weighing machine. The weight W of a body can be measured by equal and opposite force necessary to prevent in downward acceleration. Means if you want to decelerate yourself or make your acceleration due to gravity zero, then the force required to maintain that acceleration zero, it is the that force is known as weight of your body. So what type of changes we have? Variation in g, because for there are two factors. First one is change due to location, if you go one city to other city or one place to other place on earth, you will find some variation. It is minute variation, but it is important for exact calculation. And the acceleration g, the first thing is due to location. The acceleration g vary with about 1/2 of 1% with position on earth surface. It depends if you are in US or if you are in India. There will be some difference depending upon earth crust density, because you know small g depend on the mass of the earth. So mass depend upon the density. So density, height, and other some factors vary value of g, and it is very minute. G vary about 1/2 of 1%. You can imagine the position of earth surface means the magnitude wise, if you observe from about 9.78 meter per second at the equator to approximately 9.83 meter per second at the poles, means at poles it is 9.83 and at the equator it is 9.78. local variation is also there, and as I mentioned, earth crust variation, height, if you are on sea level or on a Uttarakhand's any hilly region, then you will find some variation. So now g can also change with time, and how it vary, it depend upon the sun, earth's distance from the sun or the moon. Means g also vary with the distance of sun and moon from earth. There are some contribution, these are scientific calculation you can make by certain experiments. And also variation is observable due to earth rotation and small contribution at any one place with time. So tidal variation is also there. So this is the reason, these are the reason which forced us to calculate gravity at each and every place with respect to time. Also means you have to measure in your lab what is your acceleration due to gravity in Uttarakhand Open University also. And if you want to make some experiment in US or Australia, then you will have to first calculate the exact value of g to be very precise in your experimental results. So to calculate absolute measurement, how we are calculating nowadays, there are only two basic ways of making absolute measurement of gravity, and these are timing the free fall of an object, which is very simple to explain but tough to perform. Just like, what does it mean? If you throw a particle from height h, and you may, if you drop that particle, then initial velocity is zero. Then after 1 second, its velocity will be 9.8 meter per second if we consider the acceleration due to gravity at that place is 9.8 meter per second. So by observing each and every second the velocity, you can observe the acceleration, and it is your reading or it is the value of acceleration due to gravity. But in lab, it is not possible to do that experiment of paragliding, or availability of planes are not there. So this is different way. The timing means you can time your motion under gravity by putting some constraint. Constraint is restriction that your pendulum will move in a certain way only. Then we need pendulums, and that is the reason in first year experiment, first year lab syllabus, so many type of pendulum is available. So this is the way we reach to pendulum. And what is pendulum? A vibrating body, you know, does back and forth number of times. The variation repeat themselves over and over, and as such the body will move back to and past the equilibrium position every time. it returns from maximum displacement to the right or left means a certain it repeats itself in a after certain gap. Means its frequency is same, its time period is same. Then we say that it is a vibrating body, and there are two type of pendulum always we define pendulum in two types. First one is simple pendulum, the second one is compound pendulum. What is simple pendulum? Simple pendulum is this one. First we should understand why it is simple. What is the definition? Because the point P is by which it is hang, and P to M, it is a string of length L, M is mass, and if you know the free body diagram which we do, which we write before explaining mathematics of anything, of any motion, then we have placed, this is the force of gravity, mg. We have make component mg cos theta and mg sin theta. The basic, there is a tension T, and mg and cos theta are balanced by each other. Mg cos theta and T are balanced by each other. There is a extra force mg sin theta, which work as a restoring force. Means this force try to bring this mass towards the equilibrium position. Equilibrium means where he want to rest. So, and it is the distance is L, then torque will be force into R cross F. You know the formula. So this one. So what is simple pendulum? The certain conditions are there. An ideal simple pendulum consists of a heavy point mass. Means only mass concentrate over here only. The string is massless. If you make some means if you put some mass on a string, then it will not be a simple pendulum. The very first condition to be a simple pendulum, that string should be massless. It should be perfectly inextensible. Inextensible means if you place some mass with that in a string, then its length should not increase. Or while doing oscillations, its length should not increase, but it should not vary with the time. So that should that's why it should be inextensible, flexible, means it can be able to oscillate, and weightless. So these are the three conditions which a string should satisfy to use as a simple pendulum. In practice, we make it by tying a metallic spherical bob to a fine cotton stitched thread. This is cotton. You cannot neglect. You cannot make mass zero, but you can reduce its value. That's why cotton thread are used in making simple pendulum. Length of simple pendulum is L. It depends on the point of suspension to the distance from mass of the body. So it is L over here, and the distance between the point of suspension of the pendulum and center of gravity, because this is a point particle, so its center of gravity lies here, and its distance from the point of suspension is called length of the simple pendulum, and we represent it L. And this is the motion, how simple harmonic motion you can observe by allowing your head to oscillate. And this is the simple pendulum, and by this is the mathematics we discussed, that if you want to place means restoring force, then torque is I into alpha, alpha is angular acceleration, then this torque should be equal to mg sin theta L, which we discussed in an earlier slide. So mg is mg sine theta is f, and l is r. R is the distance from point of suspension to point of suspension to center of gravity. So this is the distance r l. So r, by using r cross f, mg sine theta is l, mg sine theta into l. And what is ml square? It is the value of I. You know, by moment of inertia formula for a mass placed at a distance l from point of observation or axis of observation, then it is ml square, about which you have to calculate moment of inertia. So here, in case of simple pendulum, this formula is I equal to ml square, and d2 theta upon dt square, it is the value of alpha. So, and when we rearrange it, this one, d2 theta upon dt square upon plus g upon l sine theta for a small angle, sine theta equal to theta. So this is the standard equation of simple harmonic motion, and this is the another example of simple harmonic motion. And the time period is the formula we observe mathematically, t equal to 2 pi under root l upon g, and this is the spring mass system by simple simple harmonic motion. Here we also note down that spring should be massless to satisfy the condition of simple harmonic motion, otherwise it will not be a simple pendulum. So this is the formula, t equal to 2 pi under root l upon g. Now, what is compound pendulum? Any pendulum which do not satisfy condition of simple pendulum, we can call that that pendulum as a compound pendulum. Means any pendulum which do not satisfy condition of simple pendulum, it means we will say that pendulum as compound pendulum. Basically, it is not possible to observe practically simple pendulum, because you cannot reduce mass of a spring to zero. That's why most of the pendulums are compound pendulum. So they have bigger role to play in the lab. That's why Catter's pendulum you studied last day, or today's bar pendulum, all are compound pendulum. So most pendulum are compound and with an oscillating mass spread out over a definite volume of the space. Means if you want to perform in the maximum, I mean, suppose I have that book, and you can oscillate this one like this, is also simple pendulum, compound pendulum. So any pendulum, any object, by hanging that one and making oscillation, you can make compound pendulum. But in today's topic, we have to discuss the bar pendulum only. So we have used a bar here, this one of total length depends here. This is point of suspension, which we represented. We have represented by O, and this is center of gravity of the bar. So, and the distance is h. But in our calculation, we are using in place of h, we are using d. So it is the, let g be the center of gravity of compound pendulum of mass m about point, and that oscillate about point O, then OG equal to D. If the pendulum is moved so that, then line OG is displaced through an angle theta. Then again, the same formula which we used in simple pendulum, tau equal to mg d sine mg d theta. In place of sine theta, we have used theta, because for small values of theta, sine theta equal to theta. That's why it is mg d theta, and I equal to d2 theta upon dt square. One important thing which I missed, that for small value of theta, sine theta equal to theta, only then we observe condition of simple harmonic motion. So it is necessary while doing practicals you use smallest possible value of theta so that performance or real experiment you can perform in the lab. If you are increasing while doing experiment, if you increase or use higher value of theta, it won't satisfy the condition of simple harmonic motion and result will not be accurate. So always try to use small possible values of theta in pendulum experiment. Then it is already known. These are the experiment and these are the values. Time period is under root I upon mgd. So and omega is which is equal to 1 upon t. So omega equal to mgd upon I. What is here? But now a difference is there. In simple pendulum, we have used I equal to ml square. But in compound pendulum, you know by parallel axis theorem of moment of inertia that if you want to calculate the moment of inertia about the point of suspension about an axis passing through O means point of suspension, then by using parallel axis theorem, I equal to Ig plus Md square. What is Ig? Ig is moment of inertia of that body about an axis passing through center of mass or center of gravity and perpendicular to the bar pendulum. Then it is I equal to Ig plus Md square. And you know by definition of radius of gyration, Ig can be replaced by Mk square if k is radius of gyration about a parallel axis theorem through G. This is the formula time period, formula of time period and t equal to, so we have that value I equal to Mk square plus Md square. Now, this is the, we have given the values which we calculated in last slide, t equal to 2 pi k square plus d square upon gd. So, simple pendulum consists of mass m hanging at the end of the string of length l. The time period of simple pendulum is t equal to 2 pi l upon g. And when we compare these two equations, you will find equivalent length l d square plus k square upon d. So you can compare the time period of compound pendulum and simple pendulum. You observe the relation l equal to d square plus k square upon d. And you may see, so the time period of simple pendulum equal the time period of compound pendulum only when l equal to d plus k square plus k square upon d. And we have mentioned k square upon d as d dash. So equivalent length is l equal to d plus d dash. You should concentrate more on here on this slide because l equal to d plus d dash. What is d? D is the distance you may, yes, here d is the distance here in figure it is h. D is the distance from point of observation O to the distance of center of gravity G. So here L is D plus D dash. It means point of suspension to point of center of gravity is the distance is D plus D dash means we have to move some more distance from center of gravity towards other side. So it is D dash. Now by calculation mathematically, it is a quadratic equation. And you know, the quadratic equation has two solutions. And what is that solutions? D d1 plus d2, you know, ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, then its solution is, if the roots are d1 and d2, then sum of roots are d1 plus d2 equal to L. And by comparing this equation, and d1 into d2 means equal to k square, we have written under root d1 d2 equal to k. So these are the solution which we observed from by solving quadratic equations. So what we have observed, d1 plus d2 or d plus d dash, whatever symbol you use, it is equal to L, and under root d1 d2 equal to k. So both d1 and d2 are positive. We conclude that there are two points of suspension on one side of center of gravity of compound pendulum where the time periods are equal. Means d1 and d2 are the solutions of this quadratic equation, which it means by at these two points of value of d, means if d equal to d1 or d equal to d1 d2, at both for both of these values, time period will be same. This is the most important observation from the theory, which we will use in the practical. Similarly, there are two points of suspension on the other side of, because we are discussing for one side. Similarly, there will be two points other side. So totally we will get four. Thus, for a compound rule, there are four points of suspension, two on either side of center of gravity where time periods are equal. If you understand these things, that for a compound pendulum, on both sides of center of gravity, there are two points where time period are same, then we will observe this property while discussing experiment. So the simple equivalent L is the sum of these two point of suspension located asymmetrically on two side of the word. Here word is asymmetrically. Why we are using asymmetrically? Because d1 and d2 are not equal. d1 and d2 are not equal. That's why we are using word asymmetrically. Now, it is bar pendulum, which is available in all labs. And these are the requirement for us: bar pendulum, meter scale, stopwatch. Sometime in labs they use telescope also to observe these experiment. In bar pendulum, if you observe that there are certain holes, and here top end we named it as A, and the bottom end is B. And there are equidistant holes by which you can suspend your pendulum by using knife edges. Edges is there at point A by which it is suspended. By using these holes, you can suspend this bar pendulum at by different length. Means you can vary your distance from center of gravity to point of suspension. That's why there are so many holes. If in standard, generally it is 1 meter, the length of A to B is 1 meter. So by dividing equally, means you may sometime you find 10 hole bar pendulum and 20 hole bar pendulum. Means you can divide into 20 parts. So if there are 20 parts, then top end A and first hole distance, you can calculate it may be 5 centimeter and 10 centimeter depending upon the apparatus you are using. Then again, first hole to second hole is distance is same. Third, second to third, same. Means it is equally, means distance between two holes is same, constant. And by placing different by placing knife edges in different hole, you can suspend this bar pendulum in a different position. So what is the procedure? The compound bar pendulum AB is suspended by passing a knife edge through the first hole at the end A. very important thing I missed here. In this, there is a mistake in the diagram. What is that? There is one question which you can you may ask that by placing knife edge, you are adding some mass in the bar pendulum. So will the center of gravity will shift or not? Of course, it will shift towards the higher mass, means towards end A. So in the lab, what we do, we place another knife edge of same mass, same distribution of mass at the end B, so that the center of gravity remains at its original position. Now, what happens? Now, if you place first knife edge in the second hole, then during experiment, you will have to place the second knife edge in the second hole also. What I mean? You have to make sure that your center of gravity remains at the same position. This is the reason that while doing experiment, we always use two knife edges. So the compound bar pendulum AB suspended, the pendulum is pulled aside through a small angle. Pull it and release it, just like simple pendulum, whereupon it oscillates in a vertical plane with a small amplitude, and the time of oscillation 20 is measured. 20 oscillation is measured. It is not very compulsory that you should measure 20 oscillation. You can use 10, you can use 30, you can use 40, depending upon your time availability of time. But more oscillation will give you more accurate result. That's why we use 20, 30 or 40 oscillation in lab. We recommend in the lab around 40 oscillation you should use, so that accurate results can be obtained. From this, the period T of oscillation, means time period T of the oscillation of pendulum, is determined by using this, by measuring the time of 20 oscillations by using your stopwatch. In a similar manner, you will place pendulum in different holes and suspend it, and you can measure the time period. The bar is then inverted. Starting from A, you will do the experiment. Then again, you will by starting from B, you will do the experiment, and you will note down the time periods for different D. The distance D of the top edges of different hole from A of the bar are measured in each hole, and the position of center of mass of the bar is found by balancing the bar horizontally on a knife edge. How you can calculate your center of gravity, I will show in the demo which I recorded for you. The mass M of the pendulum is determined by weighing the bar with an accurate scale or balance. You can do that. This is the table. You can see this is the bar pendulum where point A and B is there, and G is the center of gravity. For here, number of holes from A, you may write first, second, third, fourth, and distance of knife edges from A, you will in centimeter you can write it. Number of it is written in 10 oscillation, depending upon 20, 30, 40, whatever you are measuring, you can write it here. In first one, it, you can write in minutes, in second, seconds, and it is total time, mean time, and by dividing it, total number of oscillation, you can find the time period. And this is the table for calculating, for drawing the graph. So length of equivalent simple pendulum by AC and BT. How we can I'll explain later on why this shape is here. Or you can understand by simple pendulum or the formula that if you observe, this is a quadratic equation. The shape of the quadratic solution of quadratic equation give you when. This one. If you see L equal to d square plus k square upon d, in that formula, if you vary the value of d, you will find different time period. So it is not constant, it depends on d. That's why we observe different time periods, and when we plot here the vertical line, vertical axis show the time period and horizontal axis show the distance from point A, means here it is 0, then 20, then 40, then 60, then 80, and then 100. The horizontal x-axis show the distance of hole from point A, and the vertical line shows the time period, which corresponding time period which you observe for that value of hole from the center of for end A. I have made a table also. How we can draw graph? The graph is drawn with the distance d of various hole from end A along x-axis, the period t of the pendulum at these holes along y-axis. The graph has two branches which are symmetrical about g. To determine the length of equivalent simple pendulum corresponding to any period, a straight line is drawn parallel to x-axis from a given period t on y-axis. Means to determine length of the equivalent simple pendulum, if I move backward in this graph, you can observe that the point A and B, you can make a graph. If you are observing for time period about 1.5, this is the time period. Time period about 1.5, if I draw a horizontal line, what we observe, it this line crosses this graph at four points, which we have discussed. 2 points towards point A, means towards one side of the center of gravity, and C and D are the 2 points which we observe in next half of the center of gravity. So there are four solutions, as we discussed, and at all these four solutions, you may see that time period is same at A, B, C, and D. All these points have same time period. Means we have observed our four solutions through the graph. By measuring these values, means PA, PB, PC, PD, you can calculate D1 and D2 as we discussed. And by putting this formula, this in the formula, we can calculate center of acceleration due to gravity G. So this is the here I have mentioned that the cutting the graph at 4 points A, B, C, D, we can observe the D1 and D2. The distance AC and BT, BD that determined from the graph are equal to corresponding length L. The average length L equal to AC plus BD by 2. Why we are saying AC plus BD by 2 and L upon T square are calculated? Again, I'll take this point again. So wait for a minute. In a similar way, after calculating L, AC plus BD by 2 and L upon T square, you can calculate G. In a similar way, you will draw another line, another horizontal line parallel to x-axis for different time period, and you calculate L upon T square. By calculating different L upon T square, you can calculate G by this using this formula, G equal to 4 pi square L upon T square. You may observe that L upon T square should be constant over all periods T. So the average over all suspension points is taken. Finally, the acceleration due to gravity is calculated from equating G equal to 4. From the equation G upon J, this one. This is the important point because G should remain constant ideally. So you will get for different length and for different time period combination, you will get same G. Number of holes from A. If you check it from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In video I have mentioned there are 19 holes are there, and by marking it one by means first hole as 1, second hole as 2, and distance from A in centimeter is 5 centimeters. The second hole is at 10 centimeter from this A. The number of oscillation I have calculated the value for 20 oscillations. The total time for oscillations, if you watching, means this is 32 seconds. This is 31. Means as you increase your distance from A, its time period is time period is reducing, and starting from 1.6, then it become 1.575, then it become 1.535, then it become 1.5, means it is reducing, and after that it again increases, means 1.5, 1.475, 1.6, means it starts to gain, and 1.7, 1.925, 2.725. Means what we are you are observing that initially when the distance is small, its time period is large, but as you increase your distance, its time period decreases first, then after certain distance its time period again increases. So the curve which you observed earlier, this one, this is the shape of the curve which we observed according to the graph or according to the table I mentioned here. In the second half also, here this is at 10th. Why I have not mentioned the values, because in 10th number of hole, means 10th hole, this is the point of center of gravity. In formula, when you put center of when you put your knife edge at center of gravity, you will find that at center of gravity the D will become zero. d due to d becomes zero, it is not possible to bar pendulum to oscillate. So the, it will not perform, and we will not be able to perform in that experiment. So the value, because its time period is so large, and you cannot observe oscillation over there. Again, in the second half, after 11th, you can observe the repetition of first half. So these are the values in second half. Means 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, 17th, 18th, 19th hole. And its distance from A in centimeter are 60, 65, 70, 75, 80, 90, 95. And so these are the values. When I plotted this one, these are the graph. And you can observe this graph is earlier one. I mean, same like earlier one. And you can check. Initially, when the distance is zero, the graph means time period start to decrease till point E, and then again starts to increase. And at center of gravity, means at point G, the time period, the curve show time period is infinite. And again, by increasing your distance from A, means around 60, you get the point C, and this time period starts to decrease, and after reaching point F, and after reaching point, it again starts to increase. So this is the symmetry of the curve in both half of the bar pendulum about center of gravity. Means A to center of gravity, initially time period starts to decrease and then again increases. In second half, first it starts to decrease and then again starts to increase. So this is the observation we have. And graph plotting. The graph is drawn, again I am repeating that slide, graph is drawn with the distance d of the various holes of AND A along x-axis, means in previous table, this one, the distance A in horizontal axis and time period in vertical axis. When we plot it, we get the same graph, and this is the procedure. The graph has two branches which are symmetrical about G. To determine the length of equivalent simple pendulum corresponding to any period, a straight line is drawn parallel to x-axis from, and now how we can make calculations for calculation for calculating G. So we will draw, it's our choice, it is not compulsory that where you have to write, where you have to place a line. In this graph, I have placed a line at t equal to 1.5. This line crosses at four places, A, B, C, D. We will note down the value of AG and BG, means, sorry, AP and BP, and PC and PD. Now, what is the value of D1? Suppose I am taking the distance A to P as D1, then the D2 will be P to C, because point A and C are asymmetrically placed. Similarly, point B and D are asymmetrically placed about point P. So either you take AP as D1 and PC as D2, or you take BP as D1 and PD is as D2. So these are the point. The distance AC and BD determined from the graph are equal and corresponding length L. So it, you can, I was mentioning it D1 and D2. And when you add these D1 plus D2, then by the formula which we have already calculated, you can find equivalent length L of compound pendulum or bar pendulum, AC plus, by adding AC plus BD. The average length. So what is the, why we are taking average? Because we have four combinations. four points. So we have two combination. Either we should take AP plus PC or BP plus PD. So we will take both of them, and we after adding them and dividing by two, you can take average value of the L. That's why we are using this formula, average value. And by calculating L, the corresponding T is known by graph already. So by using L and T, you can calculate L upon T square for one horizontal line which you have drawn in your graph. Again, in a similar way, L upon T square is calculated from different period by drawing lines parallel to x-axis from the corresponding values of T along y-axis. This was the one combination. For different combination, we will draw another horizontal line, we will get another L, we will get another T. So we will calculate L upon T square. Similarly, and finally, the acceleration due to gravity. This is the equation which we will use. And determination of K. Actually, there are certain how we can calculate K. If you go into theory of bar compound pendulum, you will get in the formula. If you calculate the minima and maxima, by differentiating equation of the formula is there here. G equal to 4 pi square L upon T, and formula is T equal to 2 pi under root L upon G. If you differentiate it with respect to L and get minimum value, maxima and minima. For maxima and minima, you will get at L equal to K, means when your equivalent length is equal to K, the time period will be minimum. So from the graph, there are two methods to calculate K. One thing is, if you see in the graph, there is a dotted line which is horizontally placed, and there is a minima at E and F. So at point E and at point F, the time period is minimum. These are the point of minimum time period, and the distance of G from E or P from E, means horizontal distance from center of gravity of these point, is equal to the radius of gyration. It can be mathematically proved. So you should consider, or you should always and it gives the value of K. To calculate the value of K, determine the length AP, BP, PD, PE in the line AB, PED, and compute AP and BP or PD into PE. So this is the different method. By graph, you can calculate the value of K, or by measuring the length AP, BP or PD, PE, means the formula which we have earlier calculated, the under root D1 into D2 equal to K. By using that formula or by using graph, you can calculate the value of K, that is radius of gyration. It is your choice and it is your convenience. Then again, finally, toward the errors. So you know the standard method: by taking log in the formula and differentiating, you will get the dg upon g and dl upon l, and the formula you can get by differentiating. And by placing the maximum errors which is possible in calculating L, means your least count for L is if it is in centimeter or it is in millimeter, and T for second, you can calculate the value of G, maximum error in calculation of G. it is the standard procedure which we use. Or percentage error you may calculate. Suppose your value is 9.83 and standard value is 9.8, then you can differentiate, you can take a difference and you can convert it in the percentage of error you get in the lab experiment. These are the precautions we can take. Error is introduced due to resistance of the air. Exactly, the problem is you always do experiment in physical situations. So there is will be air, resistance of the air. Knife edges are not very free. There may be some resistances. Support may be stable or unstable, means there may be some vibration in the support where you are suspending your power pendulum. Some error may be there if you you are using theta, larger theta, because then normal simple harmonic motion equation cannot be satisfied over there. Or you should use two knife edges symmetrically with respect to center of gravity. The distance should be measured from knife edges. The graph drawn should be free and hand curve. So these are the precautions. Now I will, this is final. So now I will ask some questions if your time permits, and if it, this is the procedure.